Well, hello there. I think you would like to see what's going on inside my journal. Now, this journal I created over the span of about 3 or 4 months. And the prompt list I followed was the 30 days of self-mastery and transformation. And on the front cover, it says, joy, if absent, is simply a way of life not yet discovered by you. So, if there is something you need to explore in your life, if it's a self-mastery journey, if it is something where you want to overcome resistance, whether you want to find greatness, or whether you just want to spend some time with yourself in a loving, caring connection, this 30-day self-mastery and transformation companion document would be the perfect companion for you to take on that journey. So, in my journal, I'll just put this aside. It is available for you to download. I have supplied a link in the description or in the comments, depending on where you're watching this from. And I'll just go to the journal for a minute. Now, this journal was created out of loose sheets of A4 paper that we folded in half, and then later took each of those four-page signatures and put them together in a text block like this one. Used a, I don't even think this is a specific technique. I just tied them all together as each booklet was bound individually, and you can keep them individual if you like, but I like to have a collection of little journal pieces together like this and then build on that. So I'm going to page through the front of the book all the way to the back, but you'll see that the tabs here show day 3, day 27, day 20, and so on and so on and so on. And that's because I will sit down and I'll page through the whole book, then decide where I want to create something, then go to the prompts list and follow that prompt as closely as possible. All right, so right here in the beginning is just a page where I wanted to reflect on, those once upon a time fairy tale dreams I used to have. And how I used to tell myself, yes, you are worth it. Yes, you can have it. Wear your crown. Right? So, just a little inspiration notice here. Our membership runs on eight values: gratitude, compassion, authenticity, or in other words, personal truth, growth towards goals, connection, mindfulness, purpose, and when I'm talking about purpose, I'm talking about three levels of purpose: the purpose of self, the purpose of career, and the purpose of others. And then the eighth value to create joy in your life is resilience. So you'll see throughout is a little inserts of these tracing papers of old projects that I just wanted to not have a bunch of loose leaves of paper lying around. So I incorporated that into this journal. So values for life, and they are together. This is just that little inspiration piece for day three. So let's go to day three and see what day three was all about. Day three was a self-portrait. The activity was create a self-portrait. This can be a realistic, abstract, or a photo of you focused on how you see yourself and how you want to be seen. And the prompt is create your self-portrait with any means possible to reveal a possible trait about your self-image and the qualities you value in yourself. All right. And that's what I came up with. Number two, a special place vision. Now you can download this and read through all of that all on your own. I'm just going to go on and read the specific day and that specific day's context. All right, day 27. Gratitude journey. Day 1. Create a gratitude list. Day 30. Final reflection. Create a final artwork that encapsulates your journey of growth. Now, this month had, the month I was working on this had 31 days. So therefore, I have a number 31 there, but there isn't a number 31 in the prompts list. This is just a place I want to visit in Tasmania. Mushrooms are so easy to draw. Did a little bit of experimentation. And not every single page in here is based on the journal, because I come to my journals every morning as a way to inspire my day, to also step into that calm state. And in the evenings, I could come back and complete the page because I only set a 20-minute timer. And whatever appears on the page, appears on the page. And like this one, I've come back to 3 or 4 times and pulled it out in layers and created a whole scene. Whereas this background was done in less than 20 minutes. And then I added a little card on top. So this whole spread, I do go over in the Self-Mastery membership. It is a whole section on gathering wisdom and finding things to help you grow. Number 8. Dream big. Now, this is something I've been dreaming about, and I won't bore you with the details right now. Let's move on. 7. Reflection and a little planning, which is a Sunday activity. Then 20. So this one I did on our trip to South Africa on the aeroplane. And number 20 says, creativity as meditation. Just something I followed along with. 23, personal affirmation. It's better to explore life, make mistakes, than to play it safe and explore nothing at all. Sophia Loren. 21. So clearly I did that page before I did the quote. Reflection and rest. That's a little collage piece, though. Picture of Sophia on top of a background. And a little fairy girl looking at the ground or at her feet or something. So this is 22. Integration of insights. So that's just me talking about why all these things exist, why I have the membership, and it's to unlock the rose within. The rose means to be able to go through all the seasons, grow at a rate equal to your abilities, resilience through creative problem solving, and directed purpose. Oh. Observance of your behaviors to change your reality. Self-mastery in controlling what you do and growing into the person who can. Emotional well-being with stability and flow. Balance your output based on proper input. The spilling coffee story. That was a good one. Making good use of your time, creating freedom for your mind, relaxing your body, breathing more, becoming you. And then day four. There it is. Strength block. Well, that is still something I need to work on. This page tore when I tried to, somehow it got stuck in my journal. So I just tore it out and then tore it some more. So I need to cut that out and somehow incorporate it on this page. But that's a session for another day. Number five, future self projection. Now you'll see that I often use acemic writing to go through my thoughts and to express what I'm thinking and feeling. And yes, I'm pretty sure we did this page, but I don't know when. 29. Later to my future self. Again, using the acemic writing. Then 28 is inspirational quotes. So I only have one quote here, and it's something I had to tell myself. All of life is a dance to the songs you hold inside. Allow your rhythms to connect and make those fairy tales come true. There we go, my own quote to myself. Number 19. Oh, I remember. It was a song I heard. Very random. Art and music. So David Bowie, was one of the greatest of our musical artists. And when I heard the song, I just thought about how we could all better ourselves. And of course, the song Cat People, Putting Out Fire, really corresponds with my little kittens I traced from Dominique's homework book many, many years ago. So that was 19, art and music. 16. Artistic interpretation of emotions. So for me, sunflowers are pretty and vibrant, and they wake up with the morning sun and they follow the sun throughout the day. And that is such a beautiful thing we could take from nature. This is just something that I played with while doing these couple of pages. Or collage from either magazines or some of my old sketchbooks. This one was from 2021. And I just cut that out and bring it in here. Yes, and reimagine it. Number 14. Reflection and adjusting the plan, a Sunday activity. So I just talked about a few things there, not much that I need to share with you, but it was about making time for myself and doing something fun. 13 is a visualization exercise. Now, I can't say any more about this except that I was playing with colors, imagining a colorful forest, and then looking in the far distance at the forest trees on the mountains. 26. Future roadmap. So I'm always using analogies and little ways of expressing what we do in the Self-Mastery Membership. And this SPARC, SPARC, stands for Spiritual Meaning and Purpose, Personal Well-being and Stress Relief, Awareness, Curiosity and Observance, Resilience, Quality of Life and Creativity, Connection, Experiences and Engagement with Others. Happiness equals whole human wellness with a balanced, realistic look at the responsibilities. No. A realistic look at the possibilities going forward. And she looks like she doesn't really care. She doesn't have a care in the world. Number six. Create a geometric pattern. So the geometric pattern was created in the back, and on top of that was another page I took out of a very old sketchbook journal and just collaged it on top of that geometric pattern. 25. So this double spread is prompt 25. Celebrate success. And each of these little drawings has a little something to do with a success I had. And all my successes are always tied to love. So this little spread is something really special. And I enjoyed creating it, even though I wished I had spent more time to plan out this little filigree border here. But I can always come back and add to that at some point. Nine. Nine is add one smaller goal. So remember in prompt eight when I showed you the big dream. Now, this number nine is really about making sure I do add in that little extra building with the outdoor patio area that has like a fire pit and a little social area for the Lavender Cottage so that we can come together at least once a day or maybe have a sacred secret place we could go to be creative. Then 24. Visual storytelling. So for me, a picture is worth a lot in terms of what I can express. And the colors play in with the feeling or the vibe I want to create. And this is just a representation of what I want a place like this to feel like. All right. What's next? Well, number 10. Obstacles or solution? So overcoming obstacles means we get to go slow. We can have a plan. We keep our promises. We make time to reflect. We adjust along the way. We observe what works. We go faster. We discover what's the easiest next step to take. We discover who can help us. How fast can we get stuff done and ready? Can we take a new approach? And we have to keep on taking action. That's the best way to overcome those obstacles. Well, accountability pardon. So that's part of the observation and solutions or solutions where you have someone who can help you, or a group, or a community, or just a close-knit network of people that can help you. Each one of them can help you in different times. And Each one of them will have a specific skill or a gift skill and an ability to help you when you really need that help. 18. Abstract art. So this is just a little playful watercolor scene with some gold. Just something abstract, nothing too spectacular. 15. Explore new mediums. So this looks like watercolor, but it's actually ink. And this here at the bottom was, I think, gouache. Yes, I think it was gouache because it feels kind of rough and matte. And then again, these were old pages from random loose sheets that I just brought in here. So I can't show you what's in this section here, but that's part of where I helped somebody unravel the mysteries around how they can create a membership. 17, nature inspiration. So this whole spread is just flowers and blossoms and dandelion flowers, one of the old roses in, I think it was a postcard that had a spill or something on it. I cut it out, put it in here. So this was my nature inspiration spread. And that's it. We've literally gone through all 30 days, and I hope you've found something that could truly inspire you to take on a 30-day challenge of your own, where you can help to build and create joy in your own life. Remember, the 30-day self-mastery transformation companion document is linked below, either in the description or the comments. And you also get to join the Sketchbook Journal Facebook group, which is our online group. It's available for anybody who wants to join. I don't share a lot there, or at least not every day, but it's there for all of us to share our creative journeys. Our membership runs on eight values: gratitude, compassion, authenticity, or in other words, personal truth, growth towards goals, connection, mindfulness, purpose. And when I'm talking about purpose, I'm talking about three levels of purpose: the purpose of self, the purpose of career, and the purpose of others. And then the eighth value to create joy in your life is resilience. I hope to see you inside and have fun. Enjoy your 30 days and come back to your journals and page through them and help your own life become happier. If you want more lessons like this and a way to incorporate mindful sketchbook practices, please join us in the Self-Mastery membership made for creatives.